Imagine today you and your friend got equal amount of seeds to sow in your field, but you sold them to someone on the same day so that you could earn profit, and your friend sowed the seeds and let them grow for a few years till it gave new seeds. He sowed the new seeds and continued this for years and sowed a lot more seeds than what was eventually bought. By investing his seeds, he would have made profit quite different from what you made by trading your seeds. This is simply the difference between trading and investing. You must be wondering that when we compare trading versus investing returns, what turns out to be the better option? You might also have other questions like, from the perspective of someone participating in the stock market, which one is better, trading or investing? Who makes more money, traders or investors? And so many more questions. It all boils down to the inherent difference between trading and investment. We will unearth the differences between trading and investing and which approach is better suited for which type of investors. Hello everyone, I'm Sakshi Sudhani, a second year PGDM student from SPGMR Mumbai and a qualified chartered accountant and company secretary. The video, a quick announcement about a program that can help you learn about the world of finance better. Inside IIM and all TUNY has come up with a dedicated program named Finance Career Flow, where you can learn from the best in the industry. More about the program would be discussed later in this video. Coming back to these concepts, trading and stock investing are two approaches by which a person can make money in the stock market. However, more often than not, they are used interchangeably. Stock market entrants, not knowing the clear difference between the two, apply trading strategies in investments and lose money as a result. In reality, these approaches differ greatly with respect to attitudes, risks involved, as well as the time horizons. Now let us discuss the basic difference between investing and trading. Firstly, differences based on time horizon. Let us understand this with an example. Suppose that you have money and you buy a house in a good locality. Within 2 weeks, the price of a property increases and you sell it for profit. This is called trading. However, if you purchase a property because you know that it has immense long-term appreciation potential, and since it is built next to, say, a national highway, or something is going to come up in the locality, hence it is wiser to hold on to that, it is basically investing. Differences based on attitudes also play a crucial role here. The final difference actually lies between the personality or wealth creation attitude of the investor or the trader. Let us see the main difference between traders and investors. Traders think from the perspective of buy and sell. Investors think from the perspective of buy and hold. Traders take decisions within minutes, days, weeks, or maybe months. However, when investors think about it, they think about the long-term consequences. Hence, the time ranges from years to even decades. Traders try to time the market. Missing the right time to enter the market or exit the market may lead to a great loss for traders. However, investors do not time the market or get bothered by short-term market volatility. When it comes to traders, their strategy is based on technical analysis, momentum trading, etc. When it comes to investors, the stock selection strategy is essentially based on the fundamental analysis of the business and also related to value investing. Traders require real-time data and quick information to make buy and sell calls. Investors are a little more relaxed in their disposition and information only regarding the fundamental aspects are needed. When it comes to the risk appetite, traders have a more risky appetite with a penchant for short-term gains. However, when it comes to investors, they possess a lesser risk appetite and invest in the long haul. Traders do not pay attention to what the company does, they only focus on the strip price and the trading volume. However, when it comes to investors, they base their decisions based on the conviction of the company's growth prospects. Traders are more likely to buy stock based on recommendations by friends and other stock market traders, even media news. Whereas investors only invest when their investment objective aligns with the business. They do their own research and invest only after he is convinced of the potential of the business. There is another key difference, the difference that is based on the risk return. Although both trading and investing involves the financial markets, trading and investments are really two different activities with different aims. So comparisons and generalizations can be tricky. Overall, though trading is riskier, it is for two reasons. Firstly, it involves a lot of speculation, that is, quick decisions, educated guesses, and even just plain gambles. Also, it demands minimal or no diversification since it's difficult to monitor more than a few stocks or more than a few trades. Also, diversification by its evens out nature might mitigate the ups and downs and not help the trader in maximizing the return. However, it should be noted that trading can also mean higher returns. Investors may hope to earn 8 to 10% on their portfolio per year, but the trader can hope to earn somewhere close to around 5% even per month, which could end up to a compounded annual return of around 60%. For these reasons, it is difficult to crown either strategy as the best approach for stock market. If you have a low risk tolerance and you want to avoid the volatility, go for investing. But if you are a little more riskier and you would like to take chance to earn big returns fast, trading would be more appealing. Long-term investing and trading are two very different methods of approaching your ultimate financial goal. Whichever strategy you choose depends on whether you would like to get into the day-to-day or even minute-to-minute ups and downs of the market, or you'd prefer to ride on the long-term fluctuation. As long as you have the goal in mind, a plan in place, and the patience to get there, you can use trading, investing, or even a mix of both in your portfolio strategy. Traders need to act dynamically and buy and sell on the current trends, while investors study companies very closely. They invest and hold it for a longer period of time. To learn more about such concepts in details and get a better idea about the world of finance and investment banking, register yourself with the Finance Career Pro program brought to you by Inside IIM and AllGen. It will help you learn about the mechanics of finance and investment banking along with some very important concepts and domains taught by IIMA, BI and XNRI alumni who have worked with marquee companies in the past. Understand about investment banking, learn about different stocks and the future of finance. Also learn about how to apply financial management concepts through this program. If you're interested in the Finance Career Pro, enroll yourself today. The link is in the description. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode with more such finance tips and concepts. Thank you.